Oh yeah, fam, it's morning time. Welcome to the celebration, Morning Motivation. I am Deacon Ford, and we're here once again to give God all glory, all honor, all praise. For this is the day that the Lord has made, and we shall rejoice and be glad in it. It's morning time, family. Let's get into this word and see what the word is saying. Okay, it is morning time. Morning to you. Morning to each and every single one of y'all. Thank y'all for logging on, being part of the Morning Motivational family. Thank you, Sister Stephanie, Mother Hoya, Deacon Doc, Sister Allison, Sister Robson. Good morning to you. Good morning to you, cuz. Good morning to you, Sonya. Good morning, time. Oh, yeah. Thank you for being here, Sister Allison. It is morning time. Y'all see this in the Word. Red letters to the Jesus said it. Good morning to you, Sister Allie. Good morning to you. Bro, Emery, good morning to you, brother. It is morning time. Oh, yeah. Then you give me a sign. Good morning to you. Good morning to you. My brother Free, good morning to you. Listen, y'all, it is morning time. Welcome to the celebration. This morning, we are celebrating the breath of life. God has done it again. He blessed us all. He put us on the wake-up list. Despite what we're going through, despite what we got going on, He decided that we should be here this morning. He gave us another day, another opportunity in life. So God is great, and He is worthy to be praised. This morning, y'all, we're going to continue in the series. We're looking at Matthew chapter 5. This morning, we'll be looking at verses 10 through 12. Matthew chapter 5, verses 10 through 12. He called you blessed. He called you blessed, Brother Terrence. He called you blessed, Daisy. He called you blessed, Big John Russ. He called you blessed, Sister Cheyenne. He called you blessed, Mother and Deacon Robinson. It is morning time. Thank you, man. If you woke up, that's what my brother say. My brother Emery say, if you woke up, you blessed. He called you blessed. And this morning, we're going to dive into Jesus' first public sermon, verses 10, 11, and 12 of the book of Matthew. But before we get into it, y'all know what we got to do, man. Y'all come on in real quick. Big hug, man. I love y'all. Good morning to you, man. Thank y'all for being a part of the Morning Motivational family. Shout out to each and every single one of y'all. Those who are on the live right now, those who will be logging on at a later time, those who will never make themselves... known. You don't comment, you don't share, you don't do anything, but you still view, man, and we appreciate you being a part of the Morning Motivational team. Shout out to y'all who are still logging on, man. Sister Regina, Mother Tyson, good morning to you. Sister Tarasha, good morning to each and every single one of y'all, and thank y'all once again for being a part of the family. Deacon Doc, I see you on here. Let us pray, then we're going to get into this word, all right? Gracious and eternal Father, as we come to you this morning in the mighty name of your Son, Christ Jesus, Father, we come to praise your name. We come to give you glory. We come to lift you up. For you said if you be lifted up, that you will draw them all unto you. As we open your word this morning, our prayer is that you will bless us with wisdom, knowledge, and understanding of the things that we read, that you would allow your Holy Spirit to guide us into all truth and revelation. Father God, we thank you and we love you. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. Matthew chapter 5, verses 10 through 12. The word reads, blessed are those who are persecuted for righteousness' sake, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are you when they revile and persecute you and say all kinds of evil against you falsely for my name's sake. Rejoice and be exceedingly glad, for great is your reward in heaven, for they persecuted the prophets who were before you. Blessed are those who are persecuted for righteousness' sake, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are you when you are reviled and when they revile and persecute you and say all kinds of manner of evil against you falsely for my name's sake. Rejoice and be exceedingly glad, for great is your reward in heaven, for they persecuted the prophets who were before you. May God add a blessing to the reading, the hearer, but most importantly, the doer of his holy word. He called you blessed. He called you blessed, sis. Hey, Cousin Nikki, Sister Natalie, he called you blessed. He called each and every one of us blessed right here in the Word. It's in red writing. This is Jesus' first public sermon. He went in. He had to let the people know that despite what was going on, the oppression, despite how people was talking about them, despite how all of these things from the leaders, not just regular folk, but the leaders, the ones who are supposed to be in charge, the one who was supposed to be managing the people, you know, building the people up, he called them blessed. He said, despite what all that stuff going on, man, listen, don't listen to what they got going on. Don't listen to what they saying. Don't even pay attention to what they're trying to do. Because if you are a child of God and you fit into any of these categories, if you're poor in spirit, if you're mourning, if you're meek, if you hunger and thirst for righteousness, if you're merciful, if you have a pure heart, if you're a peacemaker, if you are persecuted for righteousness' sake, because you say you want to do the right thing, you ain't doing what they used to do, and now they talking about you. Oh, man, he a square now. Oh, look at her. She thinks she all that. Because you trying to do what's right. Because you trying to leave that lifestyle alone. You trying to leave that mind, that thinking, that mindset. You trying to leave that alone, and so now they talking about you. Now they gossiping behind your back. Now they doing all this stuff because you decided to move for righteousness' sake. This is what the Word said. Blessed are those who are persecuted for righteousness' sake, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. My God, is there a greater reward? Is there a greater reward? He says theirs is the kingdom of heaven when they persecute you for righteousness' sake. It goes even further to say blessed when they revile and persecute you and say all kinds of evil against you falsely for my name's sake, man. For his name's sake. When they talking and they, and I'm telling you, he said all kinds of evil. Man, I know, man. Listen, what they say back in the days, back in school days, sticks and stones may break my bones, but names are never heard. I don't know who said that, because that ain't true, man. Because, boy, some people will say some stuff about you, boy. It'll make you break down and cry. Straight up. Some people, especially when it come from family, especially when it come from your family members, people will say some stuff about you and it will make you break down and cry. But guess what God said? You blessed. He said, blessed are you when they revile and persecute you and say all kinds of evil against you falsely for my name's sake. Man, when you going in for Jesus, huh? When you going in for Jesus, man, you can automatically count it that they going to say all kind of evil against you falsely. You might as well get ready, man, because the devil going to use any tool he can to stop you from going in for him. Don't you know, man, you the same way you held street credibility in the street, the same way them people knew you out there in the world, man, don't you know that when you get your life together, you can draw them in. He said, if I be lifted up, I will draw all men unto me. The same way when you change your life, it's some people looking at you, man, they're going to want to get their life together because they followed you. They saw you. You was the one they was looking at in the street. You may not know it. Some of us may. You influenced a lot of people. But when they see you getting your life together, when they see you done stop living that lifestyle, now you doing this, now you employed, now you going back to school, now you done started your own business, now you got a family, now you ain't smoking no more, now you ain't drinking no more, now you doing things to better your community, they gonna want to join in. That's why it's gonna be the ones that's gonna chatter about you. They're gonna revile you. They're gonna say all types of evil against you. But guess what? He called you blessed, baby. He called you blessed. That's what he said. He said, blessed. He said, rejoice and be exceedingly glad, for great is your reward in heaven. There it is again. That's twice. He talking about heaven. Great is your reward in heaven, for they persecuted the prophets that were before you. They persecuted the prophets that were before you. That means your name is being mentioned with the great prophets. Woo! That you were in that number, that you were at that caliber, that you were at that level. That they persecuted the prophets that were before you. And if your name could be mentioned along with the prophets, man, that means you are doing a great work for God. You're doing a great work for God. Don't let nobody deter you. Don't let nobody stop you. Don't let nobody distract you, derail you. Don't let nobody do any of those things. Keep going, man. Keep going this morning. You blessed. He called you blessed. It's in red writing. He called you blessed, my brother and my sister. Make sure you understand that for yourself by reading the word. That's Matthew chapter 5, verses 5 through 12. That's what we read this morning. But go back, man, from the beginning. Go back from the beginning, from 1 all the way down to 12. Read your word, man, and understand that he called you blessed. I love y'all. God bless you. Y'all know how we rock. Faith over fear. God over everything. Together, we have made love great again. Love has never lost its power. It just lost its popularity. And it's been a wrap for the foolishness, man. That's what's really holding us back. I'm telling you, bro, sis, that's really what's holding us back. We holding on to that foolishness, man. It's been time to let that mess go. Foolishness expired a long time ago. Reflection, accountability, application of the word, and preparation. God is preparing a special blessing for us, man. But we got to get our life together so that we can walk into it and fulfill our God-given destiny. I love y'all. God bless you. Come here, y'all, right quick. Boy, come here right quick, man. He calls you blessed. I love y'all. Big hug to each and every single one of y'all. Shout out to those who still logging on. Matthew chapter 5, bro. Matthew chapter 5, verses 1 through 12. Matthew, somebody put that in the chat box. So it's in the description of the video, but y'all put that in the chat box. Matthew chapter 5. Verses 1 through 12. Shout out to my man, Jose Rivera. I see you on here, big bro. You know I love you, man. Shout out to, I seen a few more people had jumped on my homeboy, John. God bless you, John. God is great and he is worthy to be praised. I see you on here, Sister Verena. God is great, man. I see you on here, Mother Roundtree. You know I love you and your husband, man. God bless each and every single one of y'all. My brother, Ramel. God is great and he is worthy to be praised. I love y'all. Big hug again, man. Big hug again. Signing off. If you don't mind, hit that share button. Let's get this message out to as many people as possible. It's morning time, fam. Morning time, fam. It is morning time. I love y'all. God bless you. Remember, he called you blessed. He called you blessed. Don't let nobody else tell you different. Don't let nobody else tell you different. He called you blessed. I love y'all. God bless you.